first thing you notice, Leslie, is just how many people we have in a film unit.
Yes, but who's that lady there with the sunglasses on?
Well, that's Gabrielle. She's the director. She's in charge of the film and everyone, therefore, obeys her instructions.
And that chap there waving his hand at the moment is obviously the cameraman, because it's the same kind of camera you showed us before.
Yeah.
And now, what's he doing there? Gonna rain, is it? No. What's he doing to your face?
He's not doing anything to my face. He's using a light meter, and that finds out how much light there is coming from the sky, so that he can adjust his camera to make sure his film picture isn't too bright or too dark.
Scene one, take one.
Hang on now, chap.
Just a second. And
Mick, hang on. Mick, go that way a bit. Hold it there. That's it.
Got the rhino?
Yep. And
cue.
Okay.
Welcome to another in our series looking at zoos all over Britain. We've come to London Zoo today, and I've situated myself near one of my favourite animals, I think, the rhinoceros. And to find out a bit about...
What's that funny thing on the end of that long pole?
That's a microphone. It picks up the sound of what we're saying.
Rhinoceros section here at London Zoo. Hello, Bill.
Tell us a bit about the youngster. How old is she?
7 months old now.
Was she... Is it rare to breed rhinos in captivity?
Yes, it is rather. We had three here born here since 1969.
Right, this is... And who's that lady on the left with the great big notepad?
Well, that's Sally, the director's assistant. She keeps notes of everything that's said, and also she times the filming with her stopwatch.
Well, there's quite a lot of difference. You see, the white rhino is a much larger animal.
And that's Ted, the cameraman, again, as you can see, making sure we've got a nice, clean, clear film.
Has a rather wide, flat mouth, whereas you notice the black rhino has a prehensile upper lip.
So she does?
She uses it for pulling twigs off the bushes.
Kind of like a bit of a trunk there.
Well, yes.
Cut. Hold it a minute. Okay, stand by, please.
Stand by. That means the problems have been sorted out and we're ready to go again.
What's that man holding that big square thing?
Well, that's a reflector, and that's taking light from the sky and reflecting it back into my face.
Ah. What's he going to do? Chopping nose off or something?
He's waking me up. Actually, that's called a clapperboard, and that's used to mark the beginning of each piece of filming.
What's happening now?
Oh, well, this is the embarrassing bit. This is where I have to sort of talk to myself. What I have to do is the camera's repositioned, and I have to ask all my questions again, without the answers, so that they can get a different angle of the
question. Oh, so they can see your close-up of your face?
That's right.
I haven't asked you their names. What are they?
How long will it take Noel to grow as big as her mother?
How long will it take? Say it again.
Gosh, what's happening now?
Now the cameraman's got a problem here. I think it was a small cloud going over, but it didn't last very long. We're soon ready to go again.
Okay. Thank you.
How long will it take Noel to grow as big as her mum?
That's about it.
That's it.